Going on, it's your boy DArmy 26 here, bringing you a brand new video here, guys. And we are here for the first highlights video of Fox Lodge's new season. They're back in the Premiership, and their first game is against Brigade Cricket Club here. They are, in my opinion, the favourites. They won it this year, so it will be a very tough fixture. Let's get straight into it. There's the team sheet, as you've seen there now, and let's go straight in. There's the first ball, Jason Mulligan and Dean McCarter in here, and Andy Britton coming in the bowl. And Jason, they're just a lovely wee flick in. He's not going to get any runs for it, but a decently well played shot. They start off the innings. Here comes Andy Rutten in here now once more, and he bowls short one, and Jace just cuts it through there, through gully, and that's going to be four runs. Lovely shot there by the opening batsman. And as Britton runs in once more in the same over here, he bowls another sort of the back of the length ball, and Jason just flicks it off the hips there, and up it goes the hill. And you know what, I think that's going to be four more, is it? Yeah, it is. Four more to Jason there. Great, great start here. And now Ryan McBath down from the other end. He's going to run in. He's going to bowl in. The Dean is going up for a big appeal. Is he going to give him out? No, that's going to be not out here. Back down the other end. Andy Britton running in. He bowls a short one. And that's smacked all the way. And it's six runs. And it hits the car as well in the car park. My God. What a shot. That's, yep, parking at your own risk. What a beautiful shot there from Jason. Now he's on the 14. Here in the third over as Andy runs in. And he bowls another back of the net ball. And that one's creamed through cover point. It's another wonderful shot from Jason. And he's already raced on the 18 runs. We get now over 3.3 here. Ryan's running in. He's going in the Jace. And he hits it straight down the ground here. And that is going to be four more. And he moves himself up on the 22 runs. It's an absolute wonderful bit of cricket here. And then he gets another one back of the length, and he hits that one over the top as well. He's hitting Andy Britton around the place for fun right now. He's absolutely smacking him around. He's moved on the 26. This is wonderful cricket. And now as we move on to the 7th over, it's going to be Ryan McBeth running on to Dean McCarter. He gets down there, going to go for a big appeal, and he's giving him LBW. Dean is out for one or two. I'm not too exactly sure, guys, because I didn't get to see the book. And what exactly what it was, if you've seen up there in the top left, I had the scores up. And that's, I had him on one, but I'm not too sure. Now the captain, Brian Allen's coming in, wicketkeeper batsman, batting at number three. Coming in to join Jason in the middle here at Fox Lodge in the opening game of the season. Guys, I won't be having this up for a long time because it's hard to focus on what the batsmen are on or off. Like, they're not going to be exactly accurate. Like it says now that Jason's on 29. I'm not too sure. That's for a fact, as you see me just over there. And now we're on to the 9th over, and it's going to be Johnny Thompson, the first bowling change, and he bowls a short one, and Jason smacked him away to the boundary as well. Four more. Wonderful, wonderful batting. Absolutely stupendous. This is amazing. And once more running, and he's had him again. He's absolutely smacked him again. When are they going to learn to stop bowling back of the length? What a road of a track this is. The ball just going to set up to be hit here. It's absolutely amazing stuff, this, from Jason Mulligan. Now, guys, these are snippets from overs 10 to 25 here. As a ball comes in there from Ryan McBeth, and it's beautifully defended there by Jason. And they're going to another one, and he's left that one. So, just taking our time now. It's a 50 over match. We do play in the whites over here in Northern Ireland. This is JT running Andy Bryan. Good leave. Very good leave from the captain. And now we're up from a different angle here. Smacked through. Oh, no, actually, he's missed it. Jason giving a throw of the hands. They move on. And Brian, oh, playing miss. A playing miss there. Getting a wee bit nervous. This is great bowling. JT running on. Bowls one to back of the length. Gets it away, Brian. Not for any runs, though. And this one comes on a short, and it's away at 6 runs. What a shot, Brian. Absolutely wonderful. Great cricket. Great stuff. And then we see Johnny Thompson continuing the run in from that end. And he bowls one, and it's just back left, and it's well defended from Jason. We're just waiting now for Johnny to run in once more. But it looks like they're getting, like, the bales might have flew off with the wind. It was a very, very windy day. That's why you don't hear any of the actual natural sound, guys, because I muted it because it was that one day, and all you'd hear is one. It'd be very annoying, and he bowls one, and it's just very well defended once more. So Fox is still batting away here now. I don't know if you can see the score, but we're 60 something here at the moment, and that's, oh, it's a wee bit just popped up there to Jason. You have to get the bat up and make sure it doesn't pop up for him. Sorry for the bad camera work, guys. As I don't know, is it still Ryan running on? I think it is. Or it might be Matty Barr. It might actually be. And that was smacked for 4 runs by BA. It's absolutely wonderful stuff. He's batting madly. And guys, I can actually tell you that Brian's now out for 28 runs. He made 4 fours in a row there off Matty Barr. And then Matty just put one outside off. We went to cream it through the covers. And he got caught at point, actually. So Brian's out for 28. Again, he said that it was a stupid shot himself, the captain. But here comes Paddy coming in now to bat at number 4. Sebo, our overseas professional, will be in at number 5. And here he is, my PE teacher, Niall McDonald, comes in. They're going to go for a big LBW, peeling Jaycee's out for 49. We were waiting in the pavilion about to cheer him up, about to give him a big clap for his 50, but he didn't quite get there. He gets out for 49, and our overseas professional, Sebo, will now come in. And I, guys, I'm going to tell you, I've never seen McDonald bowl in my life. And that was his very first over, and he managed to take a wicket in it, and I was like, is this actually happening? Like, so I have to give him his dues. He took a wicket. You have to give him his dues there. He'd probably be watching this as well, because he had quite a big moment later on in the match, and we'll soon see what that was. But anyway, Jason departs for a very, very well made and a very cleverly knocked 49. And that will help us, but we need players to go on here and make a big score, about 80 or 90. We do need someone to do that, whether it's going to be Allen, or whether it'll be Sebo. But unfortunately, that was not Allen, because he was out. I'm not too sure what he got. That's why I don't have it displayed on the screen. But Dean Mahaffey's coming in, our newly secured signing. Of course, Sebo came in to replace Marco, as Marco was unable to come back for this season, so we replaced him with Sebo. And now, our new signing, Dean, also comes in. And here comes Niall McDonald running once more from the field end. And that's Sebo just punching him down that far end. Who's got his Cape Cobras helmet? He actually played in the Ram Slam. Now Johnny Robinson running on to Dean Mahaffey. And he just lets that go. Making sure. And now, guys, we have drinks. We have a drinks break. So every 25 overs, or at the 25, at the halfway mark of a single innings, drinks come out. So at the moment, we're going to have drinks. And I'm just going to, like, sort of go over this here. We'll see. Usually the teams have their team talk through here, right, for Brigade. So you have Zip there, Aaron Haywood, and Gary McBride bringing out the drinks here. It's usually just anybody who brings it out, to be honest. But anyway, I'm going to give you a halftime. I'm going to give you a halftime match report here. So Fox has been batting very well. I think Chasey's dismissal was very unfortunate, because we would have liked him to have went on and got about 70 or 80, if not go on and get that ton, because he was definitely going to be, he definitely had the form for it. Just unfortunate that he got out LBW. And Brian as well, Brian just played a stupid shot. I'm sure he won't mind me saying that. The ball was there to be hit, yes, but you can't keep going after them every single one. So couple of players, just those two at the moment, probably could have converted their scores that they got out for, and they about 30 or 40 more than what they had whenever they got out, which would have been very, very handy to the final score at the end. I don't really know what to say about Brigade just going over the fielding tactics. I'm pretty sure they'll be saying to each other, stop bowling it short, because it's just being dispatched every single time. Dean there just getting someone for his back. So he is, because he was complaining about a bad back there out in the middle. I don't know if you got that in, but anyway, guys, I want to point out that all this here, it's being shot. There he is, my PE teacher. Just give him a high five. There he is. He's happy. He's got his wicket. He's happy. But we'll put him to shame at the end of this innings. So we will. I think he knows what's coming. And I can't wait to see it comes on as well. So yeah, that's pretty much what happens at drinks, guys. Yeah, I know, it's a sport we don't do much. You just stand on the field. At the end of 25 overs, you go get a drink. And another 25 overs, you go get some food. And you go back out and you do the same again. It's not the most exciting sport in the world, we'll say. We'll put it like that. But I enjoy it. It's a good day's out when you have all your lads just spend the day. So good, that's drinks. We're going to get back to the action here now. And it will be McDonald running in the Dean Mahaffey here, and he just hits that one straight back at him. That's going to be a dot ball. And unfortunately, Sebo was out after smacking a 6 and a 4. And he got about 20-odd then in the end. And that was our current score, 131 for 4 off 29 overs, which is not the greatest, especially on this pitch. I'm going to have to say it. So yeah, that is Sebo coming out. And Jordan Austin will be coming in now. This will be hopefully a good partnership, this. I don't even know who that is, Bowen, I'll be really honest with you. We're running in down from this end now. I think it might be Andy Britton again, and he gets Dean coming down to try and get that through the leg side, but he can't quite get it. But this ball continues to run in down from the road end, and that's been smashed through the gap there. It's a beautiful shot from Jordan Austin. I think it is Andy Britton, Bowen, you know. Yes, it is. It is Andy Britton. That's a wonderful shot from Jordan Austin for 4. And he's going to continue running in here. There's a different over right now. These are all just from different overs. And Jordan defends nicely there. Once more, Andy running into Jordan. And he's cut that through. That's going to be down for 1. Got a wee bit excited there. That might have been away for 4. But they do have that man down there. And unfortunately, Dean has to depart for 35. Played a wonderful innings with his bad back as well. Played a couple of lovely sweep shots. It was unfortunate again. He's one of those players like Brian and GS. He probably could have went on and converted a score, only about 30 or 40 more than what he had there, which definitely would have helped. But new batsman is Luke Hayes. See, I'm sorry for the bad camera work. I'm moving down into the spot where I want to record the next, and that's been flicked through down behind him, I think. Yes, it was. And now continuing the running down from this end, and that's going to be bowled, actually. Yes, Luke Hayes bowled by Andy Britton, I think it was, as well. Might have been JT, I'm not too sure. But yeah, Luke has to depart, and Aaron Haywood will now come in, one of the leading spin bowlers for Fox Lodge, along with Jason this year and for the previous years as well. So now we're going to cut to our new angle up here, get you a better view, and they're going to take a quick single. That's wonderful there from Zup and Jordan. Very well done indeed. It's going to be Jordan this time. It's going to flash that through, and they're going to single there down the third man, sorry. And that will be another one on to keep ticking them over. This time we're going to get an angle from the different end. And again, that's going to be another one on the third man. So just taking these singles down the third man very nicely indeed. Oh, and that time slipped through the fingers. Wee edge, I don't think it carried as well. I think it might have just bounced, but you have to make sure you're behind that. I do have to say that was a rare mistake in the field from Brigade. They were very, very good in the field. As we see Jordan Austin just get bowled there. And that's another wicket down. Fox Lodge are losing wickets at current intervals here, in consistent intervals, as Jamie McIntyre comes in now. But yeah, Fox Lodge not able to get a long-standing partnership, which is one of the key facts you need to get a good score, is keeping those partnerships together. And as we see there, Zup, that's a big shot. You see the ball coming flying towards me and my mates there, and that's going to be 4 more added onto the board. So we are scoring at a decent rate here, but the wickets are coming at regular intervals, which is a shame, and you can't be affording that there. As that one clean skittles Jamie, actually, from the point of recording, I thought it didn't. I thought it was just a wee edge for 4, but no, it actually clipped the top of his off stump, and away it went onto the boundary. It was that much pace. Standard of Irish cricket is getting better with the pace. Quick bowlers, and as our number 11, Gareth Haywood, comes in now, and you've seen from the team sheet earlier, he is a bowler, fast bowler. He'll be opening the bowling with Dino whenever we go out the field. So yeah, Jamie's just going to come in here now. They only need one more wicket, but as I said, guys, towards the end of the sentence, we are going to post up a score above 200, which is good. That's always good to know we are going to do that there. We're just going to have to know, as Jamie walks in, what our final score will be. At the moment, we're in about the 48th someone over, I think. So, there's the 49th over now as McDonald runs in and zaps, skies one. He doesn't sky one. That's a very good shot, actually. Out to, I think that's Coy, yeah, that's Coy, actually. A very good shot, get the single, but he's back on strike here now against McDonald, who runs in this time. And this time it's skied up. That's a long way up. McDonald's trying to get underneath it here. And he drops him. Oh, he's dropped him. Oh, he drops his student. Niall McDonald drops Aaron Haven. That's put on the screen there. That is his. That's Aaron's PE teacher. And he actually teaches me for games as well. And I find that hilarious. That was definitely the best thing that happened all innings. That is amazing. I'm so happy it happened. And then his next ball, he actually just bowls Gareth, but that's beside the point. So, Fox Lodge were all out for 205 off 49.3 overs. There's the wicket that they were bowling on, guys, at us at halftime. And further confirmation that they ended up on 205 off 49 overs all out, of course. So, yeah, that was absolutely hilarious whenever he dropped Aaron. But here going Brigade's innings and Fox Lodge bowling. Dean Mahaffey there with the first ball. It's a dot. And now we're going to see him running again. And that one is going to be given as a wide, unfortunately. Down the other end, though, and there's going to be Gareth running in. And he's nearly chopped that on. It's just came off his edge. And the ball's came forward. As Gareth runs in once more. Comes over. Oh, and another one. He's getting out of shape there, the batsman. Gareth keeps running and he hopefully will be rewarded. He does, and it's another very well bowled ball there. Continuing to get the batsman to defend and look a bit uneasy. Not solid. And this time he lets that one go past him with a good leave, actually, after very well left from the batsman. And as Gareth runs in once more, that one's going to be wee bit back of the length, but just punched Tim Matt off. And once more, pretty much video this whole over. Gareth runs in, and that's smacked all the way to the boundary. All the way to the boundary, and that's the first boundary hit of this innings. And then Dino runs in, and that's going to be hit away, and by the looks of it, that should be cut off down there. Yeah, very well fielded indeed. Very, very well fielded. And now I think it's Gareth running him once more, and this time he has been dispatched all the way again. I think that's 1-6 though. It's an absolute wonderful shot, to be fair. It's a great, great shot. And once more Gareth running. So Gareth's getting a lot of highlights here. Not so much for Dean. And that one is smacked again. Gareth not learning from a Brigade bowler that he's bowing short himself. That one is gone. So yeah, the Brigade bowled short, they were dispatched. Gareth bowling short and they're dispatched. There's Adam Walker, if you remember him from last year. And now, but Dino this time I think it was running in, and that one's going to be shot through cover point. Jamie running down, very well fielded, making sure it doesn't reach the boundary, and they only get too far, so well fielded. And Gareth continuing the run in from the field end, that is his end, and that's very well stopped by Sebo, the professional. The save runs there. And he come down the wicket here, and that one's absolutely creamed away. And that's going to be four more, is it? Unless they can get over it. Nah, it's four. It's gone. We're just waiting now for Dino. Nope, we're going to cut because that was from the last delivery. And now Gareth continuing the run in here. That one's just going to be angled away down here. As you see, I think it's Jamie running over there. It might have been Paddy. He picks it up and throws it back in. So Brigade ticking the clock over here very nicely. Fox Lodge need to get a wicket badly, I think, at the moment, as that one's hit over the mid off and they're going to get a single for that one. But yeah, Fox Lodge need a wicket here very, very badly, because if they continue to score regularly here, Brigade, they'll get this total done in no time. Like 205 is not a good total, considering there's more balls than that there, so they don't even have to go at 6 and over to get that. Which, on a pitch that was as flat and a decent wicket to bat on as it was, you could say that they should be at least getting a good a bigger score than like at least 220, 230. But then that was, like I said, an ability for players to be able to go on and make someone off their scores instead of getting out in their 20s and 30s, in the case of Jason, 49. But that's just the way the game of cricket goes sometimes against a very, very favoured Brigade side to do well this season in the league. And Foxhawks just coming up, of course, as well. So this is a wee like, stale part of the game. Overs from 11 and to 25 here before the drinks break. Usually is the most stale part of the game because that angle, it's the part whenever the power play ends and you're coming up to the drinks part, everything just happens nicely. As Aaron Haywood's now on the ball from the field end and they're appealing for a catch here. I thought it came off a bat whenever I was actually there. I thought I heard the big edge. Brian gets a good catch, but no, they're saying it's not out. And now Sebo, the overseas professional, about to run in here for his first delivery. And a Fox Hall shirt, and it's very well bowled indeed. Looking nippy out there, so he is. He had a good part time left arm medium pacer. And going to get a new angle up here now over by the far bank and facing the car park. And this is Jamie Mack running, and it's very well bowled. Brian standing up to him as well, showing very good wicket keeping. And that's well fielded there. That's very well fielded indeed. See, we're running in, of course, as the bowler. Jamie running on now, and that one's just going to be defended straight back at him. Very good ball. And Jamie's continually running here. We're getting close to the drinks break here. We're about over 20-21 here, and that one's just flicked away, and that one will be four runs just flicked away down the leg side. But Garrett McKeegan did eventually go. He was the left-handed batsman. He went for 84. He had an absolute phenomenal innings there. And it will be Niall McDonald coming in. It was Jamie McIntyre with the wicket that got Garrett McKeegan out. He played an absolute wonderful, wonderful innings. And they probably is going to be a match-winning innings in the end. But we'll have to see and wait and find out. But yeah, that's he did something which our boys couldn't have done. Go on and make a score from whenever he started well. Getting into his 20s and 30s, but we'll have to take and go. Is that one? Jamie gets another dot ball, and this time, guys, a couple of overs later here, just on the verge of Brinks, it's D Bar as now went for 37, and Luke Hayes got the wicket this time. I actually missed the wicket. I was in the club seeing about drinks, and we're going to actually come out for drinks here now, guys. And I'm going to let you listen to the team talk. So guys, we're back here now, and we're getting straight into the action once more, just after drinks, and it's Jason Mulligan now bowling down from the road end to the batsman of Niall McDonald, and I believe it's D Murdoch, I'm not too sure about the first name, as I think that's, yeah, Zip bowling down from the field end. He's continuing after drinks from down there. Jason, of course, beginning his spell after drinks from the road end, and D Murdoch did eventually go for 30. I believe it was him. If I am wrong, I am very, very sorry. And this is Johnny Thompson coming in now, as so I believe. Number 99, I believe that's his number. We're just going to see now as the GoPro's mounted on this side, and that is hit all the way out the party, and that is a wonderful catch. You can't actually see that, but he actually saved a couple of us boys who were standing out beside him, and McDonald actually did go. So he did go, and it was Dean Mahaffey who was the bowler, and it was caught by Alan Patterson. Like I said, it was a wonderful catch indeed. He was sort of wrong footed to begin with, sort of lost it, but recorrected himself and made sure he got it. So Andy Britton will come in for him. Another wonderful, wonderful player, Andy Britton. Used to play with Fox Lodge indeed. Only they had him now, Fox Lodge's chances of winning this league would be much, much higher. And that one's edge behind. Sebo gets his first wicket in the Fox Lodge colours. It's a wonderful bit of bowling. And Johnny Thompson next behind after playing with CIYMS last year, being one of the highest rated players in the Northwest this year. Sebo gets some caught behind. It's a wonderful wee nip and delivery, that one. And BA catches him. Not like a player like that there to be getting out caught behind, but a brilliant bit of bowling. And a good safe catch as well from Brian behind the stumps. It's always nice to see wickets that are out caught behind. Shows a wonderful bit of bowling. Shows the ball swinging and nipping away here. Of course, Sebo, this is his first ever game in these sort of conditions. He played a game on the Thursday before in very, very wet conditions, but this is his first proper game. And he was out thanks to a bit of uneven bounce whenever he's batting. But he's got his first wicket. He's getting used to the slowness of the pitch. But that one's been hit straight back, and that will be 4 runs this time for Brigade. I think it was Andy Britton who hit the runs. And now we're looking at them, and yes, that's going to be it. It's through the gap, and ladies and gentlemen, that will be it. Brigade have won this game by 5 wickets. So, in the end, Brigade were the better team in the day. They don't have the professional over yet, so that just shows what they might be able to do this season. But guys, Fox Lodge, after coming up from the Championship into the Premiership, playing one of the best teams in this division, in my own opinion, I think Fox Lodge did a wonderful, wonderful job and did themselves proud out there today. They take them the 44 overs, of which I think it was. They did very, very well. I think if they only had Dino, JC, Brian go on and make some of their scores, JC maybe go on and get about 70 or 80, Brian get his 50 and Dino get his 50, they probably had this game won. Like, if you follow me on Twitter, you know I tweeted out saying they're about 30 or 40 runs short, which I think it was. And I'll be honest with you, I think Brigade's fielding also saved them from that as well, because they probably saved about 30 or 40 runs with their fielding from brilliant shots hitting. They're just diving down and make sure it's not getting anywhere. But Brigade then not winning the match, guys. That is how it ended. I fear this now, because it means I can't slag off my PE teacher for dropping the catch, because he'll just say, well, they won the game. But I don't think that'll stop me, to be deadly honest. So fair play to Brigade. They did win this game against Fox Lodge. Fox Lodge will be back though next Saturday against Eglinton, guys. I have no way down to that game, so I doubt I'll be able to produce a video for that game. If anybody is going to watch that game and they want to give me a lift down, just tweet at me at DHammy26, but get everybody DHammy26, and I'll see you next time.